Hello everyone, this will be the review of game Necronator Deathwrong, and the key was provided by developer. This game is a mixture of Slay the Spire and pixel art RTS with some elements of tower defense. And I played it 5 hours. I want to show you a little bit of a run, probably not a full run, even though the runs are quite short. We could probably do one and fail, but probably we won't go that far. So let's start with options. As you can see, we have full screen option, we have resolution working properly, sliders for sound and music. So everything you want is there. Let's just check languages maybe, or maybe not, because I would have to go through all of them. Ah, let's just click. Alright, so we have a couple of them. Yeah, quite a lot actually. Yeah, that's a lot of languages. Okay, so languages are fine. The game is still in early access, I guess. It doesn't have all the content. Necronomicon is just information on the cards, on the units. There is quite a lot of it. We have spells, support skills, and units. We'll see everything in combat, so that will be a better idea. And then we have relics. So relics are just like Slay the Spire relics. There's some of them. So let's just maybe start. At this point, the game has two characters. We have the knight and the spirit, and then we'll get the third character, the seducer. As for knight, he's quite fine. I played with better success in more sensible decks. I never won this game, but I was much further. This one is very weird, and I'm gonna show you the second character, because it's just weird and it's part of the problem with the game, that some decks are just bad, and I consider them kinda unplayable, I would say. I would generally go for this, maybe one of the decks, like Fresh Meat or something, or the first one, if I wanted to succeed. I still can't, but I'm having better success with the knight, so I would say it's imbalanced, but whatever, maybe it's just me. So we'll try with this doll, Mirabella the doll, Unliving Spirit, and that's the second character. So let's just go. I'm not gonna change the seat, because I don't know which one is easy, which one is hard. We also have Endless. I never played Endless, so I will just play the normal campaign and fail. Tutorial, no, it's not needed. Okay, so let's just start the game. I'm gonna skip through all the dialogues, because that's kind of pointless. Right, so it begins as usual in those games. You have a choice to get the first bonus, Grave Grasp. That's a spell. Let's take Souls actually. You can buy something for it, like two cards or three cards, so could be useful eventually if you make it. Right, so we have battles, elite battles that give you relic additionally. Boss battle is at the end, then you have an option to rest and buy stuff, and there's also the event. So we have to go all the way to the boss, and it's really big actually, it's many many fights. So let's go with the first fight, show the gameplay. I will try to go through various notes so you see what's there. Right, so those are units we will be fighting, not like we have a choice, so we just keep going. And that's a very weird animation which shows you the battlefield. I never know what's the point of it. I always just skip it. Right, so I'm going to play on normal speed. Normally I always go for fast and I try to grind, but in this case I will just leave it as this. Right, so I'm waiting for 30 mana to throw the card, and we produce those four bowmen. They will go to the enemy and they will fight the... Okay, let's try to hit those. That's a problem because I can never time it right. Yes, I hit them. And now they will be destroyed by the castle. But we do some damage. Alright, so I will redraw. I'm trying to get units, which I don't have enough. You know, this is a very good card actually. It's gonna make a big number of skeletons. And then we send more skeletons. The tomb is actually pretty good. Those are just stationary turrets, which I can only put here. They are rather useless, unless you are defending. The bear is good, but he is 80 mana. So let's see what happens. We took this castle. It's gonna shoot the enemies. So now we are getting more mana and we have a defensive turret here. Now I can throw here the bears. And we might win. I'll just leave it at the normal speed, we'll see how it goes. I will redraw again. And we send more soldiers. Again, we have kinda useless card. This is healed, so we can use it. The rest is not very good. There's only a chance to get new cards, but it doesn't guarantee that we get any units, so it's just hard to use. Again, animation kinda pointless. And we keep going. Okay, so usually you get souls and cards. Yes, I always take units. I need some units. And now let's maybe go there. So we can heal, that's the rest. We can remove card. Actually, maybe I should do it, but I'm gonna upgrade the soldiers. Let's upgrade soldiers. Let's go for deadly soldier. Might be better. So yes, cards can be upgraded. This is helpful. It's not that many cards really, but at least they can be upgraded. And another fight very similar to the previous one. Different units probably. Again, not that we have much of a choice, we just have to push on. And it's gonna get harder. That's obvious, so... Could be just less of the animations, I think. Just keep going from fight to fight. Again, we have to wait. Normally I would speed it up. But let's just take it slow. I'm gonna use Demon Blade first. Because that's a melee unit. Then I'm gonna wait probably all the way to this, or I can actually try again to time the hammer, that was useful. We could heal them, but we don't have to yet. They might actually destroy it, we'll leave it as this. If we fail, we fail, doesn't matter really. Okay, we will just send another unit. Maybe now we heal. Now we have the tower. Usually, at this situation, you are winning if there is this one turret, the one castle on the map, which becomes a turret, then you are slightly winning at this point. So you start winning when you take this one, well, structure. But if there is bigger map, that there is, it's much more complex. You can just take one turret and win, because they can go from other side, and there is basically various paths to fight. So it's a bit different. It's kind of like a MOBA, because there is a lane and you just push towards the enemy. Okay, we'll redraw. Again, it's kind of slow, but I just want to make it slower for the sake of it, so you can see what's going on. Right, again, victory. And it's not going well, by no means. At all. Like, yeah, demon fiends are useful. That's an event, might be interesting. Participate, I'm not sure what it is. Run the gauntlet. Okay, let's run the gauntlet. Keep running the gauntlet. Right, we might get a relic. We don't. We just get a useless card. Yes, we actually did get the relic, but we also get the useless card. Okay. So, makes spells cheaper. Not very good, but well, we got it. I'm gonna upgrade again. Another unit. Let's upgrade this fiend. Make it what to do. Oh no, poison attack might be useful. So let's give them poison attack. Right. And that would be, I think that's the, yes, that's the elite battle. So let's try the elite battle. Not sure exactly what it means that it's elite, but it is. Okay. So let's see what's going on. Right, we can now change the direction, and that's very, very annoying, personally, for me. Because you have to check when the enemy is coming from and switch it. Like now, okay, we are gonna counter them, but if they come from the left, we'd have to switch it and put... Yeah, see, now they go again, same direction. It's rather annoying, I would say, this mechanic of changing. I would prefer to just have lanes. And, yeah, see, now I would have to do this and send this guy there. And, of course, I don't have enough mana, so I can't do it. So now we are having a problem. That's the slow deck, right? We're gonna take damage. Just hope that the base is gonna defend itself. I'm waiting for the bear. Okay, so we send bear to the left, we switch again. I'm gonna redraw, and I'm hoping for units. Which I got one. Which is bad. Right, we do it. Now the spell is cheaper, but I can only put it like, oh actually, I can put it there for some reason. So let's put it there. Let's put more spells into places. We might be able to take the castle if we're lucky. I'm gonna just spam here the skeletons. The bears are blocking the left side, so that's good. I'm gonna put another turret there. This whole mechanic of dragging cards into a spot is not the best, because sometimes you can't really put it where you want. You kind of misclick and then you waste your time. And if you're close to losing, not like here because we're winning, but if it's a harder mission, you can just fail because you misclick, and that's annoying. Right, so that's a destruction of the castle again. It seems easy, but it isn't. It just gets much worse. Usually I fail before the Act 1. So it just looks easy, but it isn't. Alright. It's kind of slow, even though we have a lot of units there. I would have to probably send more units. Okay, so let's get rid of it. I'm gonna switch it. Go from the left. Maybe put those for defense, but we can only put them there. That's okay. Maybe I will smash those. I don't think those demon blades will go for it, because they have quite a lot of units here. They're wounded, but we are also wounded. And now probably they will die to the castle. I'm gonna redraw and try to spam more units. Again, it's hard, because I don't have really a lot of soldiers here. Yeah, I was lucky with the tomb, but aside from that, we have kind of two useless cards here. Do nothing. I can just get rid of one and get two, but that just slows down everything. Alright, that's a win. And let's see what we get. I guess we'll get the... Yes, we get the relic. Relic is probably something good. Alright, we're gonna take the knight. And relics. Yes, this is very good. Plus 3 armor to all your units across the board. That's very good. Not sure how much armor does, but I hope it's good. Alright, so this is gonna go for the tomb, and we'll go for tough maybe. Sneaky, no, let's go for tough. Let's make tough skeletons. I think, yes, it produces tough skeletons, which does something. I'm not sure what's tough exactly, but I guess it makes them harder to kill. Now we can spend 400 souls, which is good. So let's see, probably we'll just buy all the melee units. Yeah, usually get melee units. Like this one is actually ranged, but I just buy all of them. That would be also pretty good. It would spawn skeletons. Yeah, this is okay. 3 skeletons, yes. Alright. So let's just go and upgrade. Upgrade, of course, another unit, or maybe this one. Armor breaker, exhaust, enrage. Maybe enrage is better. I'm not sure what it does, but it sounds good. Enrage. Alright. And now some situation. Okay. Collect souls more. I'm not sure if this is permanent or I think it's healing. It's not max HP, it's just temporary HP. So I could heal a bit. 100 souls is good. Squad as well. I would go for squad. Yes, we got a demon mage. That's useful. We can't buy anything. So we just continue. And probably one more. Yeah, that's just normal fight. Normal fight, okay. Right, again, I'm clicking through this thing. Okay, I will probably die. That's 3 minutes of defending, and you have to check left and right. Which is super annoying. And you can also change this one. And this is a very complex path to the enemy. So I'm just gonna throw anything. Probably sometimes to the right as well. I will probably have to take this tower, this castle. So let's defend. And it's kind of slow because I'm used to playing on fastest speed. But normally, well, normally I just go fastest speed. If I die, I die. I have to grind anyway to level 10. So I just grind before I play. I always do it in such games. Same for Slay the Spire. I first grinded all the levels and then I played. And of course I never won as well. But playing with less cards kind of makes no sense because you might need them. They will either dilute your deck, or they will make it easier, right? But eventually you will get all the cards anyway, so I always go for all the cards whenever possible. Okay, so we are kind of defending for 1 minute. I have to go for 2 more minutes. I'm gonna send those guys here. Now we have the 2 red for us. We can't kill the enemy castle because it's very powerful in survival maps. It has this bonus here that 1000% to attack the armor plus 1000 armor, so you can basically destroy it. You just have to counter enemies for 3 minutes. Which is kind of meh. Like, you can win by default, which is very weird. Doesn't make sense, because normally you just take every castle and this one is just unbeatable. But whatever. Okay. So we put a lot of units to the left. Nothing to the right, but we have turret there. I have to redraw again. I'm gonna wait, I hope. I could switch this. They would maybe take this smaller castle there. But we won't make it. Well, maybe we'll make it in a minute. I don't know. Yes, let's send those. I will put the tough tombstone there. Again, the useless card. It does. Yeah, actually, it was kind of useful, but it just makes the next card more expensive, sort of. Because first you have to play the card to get the card, and then play the card you want. So it just makes it more expensive. It's not very useful, the drawing cards. And now we do what? I don't know. Doesn't matter. Actually, I can probably speed up, because it's just 20 seconds, which should make it. I can put this there. Wait to the end. And just go back to normal, maybe. And there you go. So I will go for one more fight. So that we play one more elite, I think. This is what? Permafrost. I'm not sure what I wanted. It just slows them. The duration is very good. Like 300 seconds. Weird. Maybe this one, actually. We can redraw everything. Might be useful. Alright, so I'm gonna go one more fight and then we've sum up. Right, bear. Whatever. It's not like, again, it's not like I have a choice. I just have to go for this fight. Besides, I need a relic anyway. So I generally have to go for every elite. I'm gonna speed up this time. If we fail, we fail. Alright, so they might go from left. Actually, they might go from left. I'm gonna send them to left first. Like maybe this one to protect. Smash them. And I will just send all the units to the left. Hoping that we take this turret. If we lose, it's okay. I will just level up the character, so that's fine. It's not necessarily stronger if you level up the character. That's the problem. It might be stronger, but doesn't have to be. Sometimes you just dilute the deck because you get too many cards. And you might not be getting cards you want. That makes a problem. That's always the same story in those games. You either dilute deck or you don't. I'm gonna play with small one. Okay, so we blocked them a little bit. Taking damage like hell. We're just unlucky. No cards, no mana, and we lost. Okay, it's fine. So if you die... of course I could have played on slower, but still, the deck wasn't very good. Right, we get some experience. And we might eventually unlock more stuff. So let's maybe look at the unlocks. The unlocks, right? So you can get what? You can get some cards. That's probably all Tactical Mind, just different versions of it. And then, what? Overly Drawing, whatever that means. Maybe it's a deck. Yeah, I think it's a deck, actually. It's a new deck, probably. And if I go with the lady, we can unlock... Yeah, Gimme Toys, that's some card, and Cover here. So basically two cards to get. Aside from that, that's basically gonna be the same character. So the same problems will stay. You will just have two more cards to get in the draft. And the same with this guy, right? We can just get another deck to test, which might be stronger or not. And one card, pretty much. Because that's the same card, just different versions. So not much to unlock. Overall, they don't grow stronger. You just get more cards and more decks, and some of them might be better. But aside from that, you have the same power. You don't have more HP or better units or anything like it. It's pretty much the same power as always. So every run is very, very similar. And the third character doesn't exist yet. So, well, the game was quite long in the early access already, so I don't know if it's gonna ever be finished, but now we have two characters and the whole campaign to play. Not sure how many acts, because I always die in first or second, but there is a few acts from what I know. So what would I give it? It's an interesting idea for sure. Presentation is okay, even though I don't love pixel art, but it's okay for this sort of game. This very, very simplified RTS with additional mechanics of what you can use, what you can play. It's using this idea that you are on a lane and you are supposed to push, which usually causes the problem because one of the sides is usually much stronger. So either you push and it's very easy, or they push you and you can do nothing. Usually in those games it's this idea. Similarly, if you play MOBAs, it's the same option. Either you get destroyed by the enemy or you destroy them. Like if you play against easy bots, you win pretty much every time, and if you play against professional players, you get absolutely destroyed and there's nothing you can do. And that's similarly here. Like either you have a stronger deck and you completely dominate, or you get dominated and that ends your run. It's very hard to actually go past that. It's hard to win in a pretty much lost battle, and it's hard to lose a winning battle unless you just stop playing or just, you know, stop reacting or make very big mistakes. But generally, the fight is won before it started. You can say, okay, this one's gonna be super easy. I have a powerful deck and it's running beautifully. Or, well, I'm playing with bad deck. I had bad RNG and now I have to fight a boss or an elite and I have no chance. Like, now I die. And yes, you do. There's really nothing you can do. But, well, this is part of the genre. So it could be said about most games in the genre. So I'm not complaining that much. I can compare it to similar games, right? I can compare it to Slay the Spire and other games, and I must say I played better ones. So I wouldn't say it's the best game in the genre, even though it's using original idea. It's not exactly a turn-based deck builder. It's kind of RTS, tower defense, deck builder, sort of. But actually cards are just an excuse to to use spells and units that you could just push a button to send without the RNG, because the cards just give you RNG that you may not be able to play what you want, but aside from that it just acts like an RTS, very simplified one. And it's all also using this lane idea, which I don't know if this is the best idea to play RTS on a lane, because it's very simplified. It's not like StarCraft. You just have to send units on a lane and hope that your units are stronger than their units. And I played many games like that, and they are usually very simplified. So I wouldn't say that simplicity is just making them better. It's just a way to play an RTS, right? On lanes. But, well, it's not necessarily for everybody. Like, personally, I would rather play a normal RTS than a laned one. Also, lanes should be presented from top and left to right. So you have one or two or three lanes and you see them like in a MOBA. Like this presentation, if everything is like a spiral and it's a tilted visual like this, it's not top down, it's just tilted in a weird angle that doesn't help with presentation in my opinion. I would prefer to play the same game on normal lanes that just go, I would easily see which is the top lane, which is the bottom lane, which is losing, instead of those spiral labyrinths or whatever you want to call it. But at the same time, it does have quite a nice gaming loop. You want to grind, you want to unlock everything, you want to try, you want to hope for better synergy of relics and better cards, and sometimes it goes better. Many times it goes very bad, like when I played Monster Train, I kind of won once and lost over 50 times. So sometimes the win ratio is like 2% in those games. But yes, this is part of the genre and some people might actually enjoy it. I don't, but well, it might be enticing for some people that the game is kind of hard and you will lose a lot of runs until you win. Of course, if you are good at this, you will probably have better ratio, but still. For me, it's rather hard and rather frustrating. Overall, I would give it a 7, because I think it is above average. I played much worse games in the genre. So this one is fine. It has quite a lot of cards. It has two characters, couple of decks to pick. Of course, each deck can be changed. So replayability is very high, even though there could be more units. It could be something more than weird toys and undead. It could be more, but well, it's not horrible. The amount of relics is also not super awesome, but it's not bad either. It's, I would say, average. The whole connection kind of works. This mishmash of genres kind of works. Definitely, if you want to play a couple of times, you know, run after run, it's gonna keep you occupied. I played 5 hours, so that was probably like 20-30 runs, and I was sort of enjoying them. I was at least trying to level up, at least trying to see everything in the game before I give up. Also, I was trying to win. At the same time, if you win, then what's the point of playing, right? If you beat in the game, that, well, that's it, right? You especially will probably have all characters to level 10 by then, and once you win, well, you could play endless, but probably you just deinstall and play a different game. So the better you are, the shorter the game will last for you, right? So if you win in first hour, then well, you're done with the game, sort of. For me, it will be longer because I'm failing, but at the same time, I can say I'm enjoying myself failing constantly. So it's not for everybody, but it is definitely playable. Can I recommend it? Well, if you like the genre, probably yes, because you will, well, if you like deck builders, you probably want to play everyone. So why not this one? It's not the best one, so I wouldn't pay too much for it. I would say yes, if you're interested, grab it on sale. But I wouldn't prioritize this game. Like right now, I'm hoping that Gordian Quest will be good. I'm trying to buy it. I played some games I liked more, like for instance, even Slay the Spire or Grifflands was better. So this one is just one of the many, not the best, but not horrible. It is playable, but it's not top notch in genre. So for me, it's 7 out of 10. And slight recommendation, I say buy it cheap. And if you're interested in the genre, you might like it, but also check other games similar, because they might be better. They might be better for your money. But yeah, this one should also be in your collection at some point. Just maybe wait until it's finished or wait for sale. Okay, guys, so that will be it for Necronator, Dead Wrong. Slight recommendation, 7 out of 10. And I'll see you guys in the next review.